I'd like to say something about the debate we had last night. And I heard and I listened to and I respect Senator Harris. But, you know, we all know that 30 seconds to 60 seconds on a campaign debate exchange can't do justice to a lifetime committed to civil rights. I want to be absolutely clear about my record and position on racial justice, including busing. I never, 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 ever opposed voluntary busing. And as a program that Senator Harris participated in, and it made a difference in her life. I did support federal action to address root causes of segregation in our schools and our communities, including taking on the banks and redlining and trying to change the way in which neighborhoods were segregated. I've always been in favor of using federal authority to overcome state-initiated segregation. In fact, I cast a deciding vote in 1974 against an amendment called the Gurney Amendment, which would have banned the right of the federal courts to be able to use busing as a remedy. And you might guess, in the middle of the most extensive busing order in American history in my city, in my state, it wasn't what you'd call the most popular vote in the country at the time. So, Reverend Jackson, we've spent a lot of time working together over the years on a lot of issues that matter. And I know, I fought my heart out to ensure that civil rights and voting rights, equal rights, are enforced everywhere. These rights are not up to the states to decide. They are a federal government's duty to decide. It's a constitutional question to protect the civil rights of every single American. And that's always been my position. And so that's why I ran for federal office in the first place. As Reverend Jackson may be one of the few people that knows, my city was the only city after Dr. King was assassinated that was almost burned to the ground, 20% of it. The only city in the United States of America since Reconstruction that was occupied by the National Guard with drawn bayonets on almost every corner for 10 months. I came home from law school that year, and I only had two political heroes, Dr. King and Bobby Kennedy, and they were both assassinated the year I graduated. And I came home and I had a job with one of the oldest law firms in the state, a prestigious firm. And after 5 months, I decided I couldn't do it. And I ended up leaving and becoming a public defender. When I was elected, one of the first things I did is to go on a committee to try to strengthen the Voting Rights Act. I co-sponsored the Equal Rights Amendment. I supported making the Equity Act in law and make the law of the land today. I voted for the Civil Rights Act of 1990 to ban employment discrimination. I wrote the law, the provision in the law that allows the Attorney General to pursue cases involving, quote, a pattern or practice of conduct by law enforcement officers in violation of constitutional of federal rights. I wrote that law. And I used that power during the Obama-Biden administration. Our Department of Justice investigated police discrimination and abuse, including Ferguson. By the way, we worked like the devil to make sure that you should not allow police departments to buy excess military vehicles like up-armored Humvees and armored personnel carrier. You don't go into a neighborhood and police going in an up-armored Humvee or a personnel carrier. Our criminal justice reforms as president and vice president reduced the federal population by 38,000 people. Ladies and gentlemen, in the Obama-Biden administration, we commuted more sentences than the president did than the 13 previous presidents combined. We passed the support. By the way, with all due respect, I say to Chicagoans and everyone, my president gets much too little credit for all that he did. He was one of the great presidents of the United States of America. And I'm tired of hearing about what he didn't do.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.